In Forza Horizon 5, there are several cars which everyone, probably including yourself, thinks are really good. But some of them are honestly nowhere near as good as you make them out to be. So I've put together this video showcasing the top 5 most overrated cars in Forza Horizon 5. Let's get into it. So we begin with the Reliant Supervan. This thing dominates a lot of D and C class leaderboards, so it's logical to think it must be good, right? Well, if the fact it only has 3 wheels doesn't raise questions, then what will? Because even Bitcoin prices are more stable now than this thing is. What's worse is the fact that for C-Class, you generally want it to be rear-wheel drive for it to be at its best. So not only will you be almost rolling it at every turn, but you'll be spinning up your wheels too. So it's almost impossible to be consistent with. And the only reason they are so good in Rivals is because it's only the 1 in 100 laps that you complete without crashing that actually matters. In the number 4 spot, we have the Hot Wheels Bone Shaker. Now, this one is much more debatable because it's overall very OP. However, I would argue it's not as OP as people make it out to be, specifically in A-class road racing, because it has this reputation of being the car that essentially gives you a free win at every race, and that just isn't always the case, because there are certain tracks which suit other cars a bit better. In fact, in A-class road racing, the Bone Shaker is often not the absolute best car you can possibly use at a specific track. It's just the fact that the Bone Shaker is so good all round that makes it the A-class meta car. But people also forget that now the GMC Cyclone is actually not too far behind the Bone Shaker in A-class road racing. So while the Bone Shaker is certainly super OP, specifically in S1 and A-class dirt racing and cross-country, I just feel it gets a bit overrated, mostly in A-class road racing. But that's just my take, as it is with all of these. Next up, we have the Brabham BT62 in the number 3 spot. Like with the Bone Shaker, by no means is this a bad car for its class, with its class being S2 here. But when you go into an S2 class road racing online race, there's often quite a lot of people using the Brabham. While it is just about the best car overall for S2, it certainly isn't by miles. For starters, the Hot Wheels Bad to the Blade can very much compete with the Brabham. And then on the tracks full of long straights, the Brabham gets eaten by the Mosler MT900S. So the Brabham certainly isn't best at every track, which means it must at the very least be slightly overrated if so many people are always using it. For the penultimate car in this video, we have the Sierra 700R. Now, in dirt racing, this is a legit good car in classes A to C. However, for road racing, it's really good at about 2 tracks that are full of tight, twisty corners. And everywhere else, it's a bit of an underperformer, mainly because it lacks straight line speed. But everyone seems to forget that it isn't that good everywhere else, and therefore it is generally considered as quite a decent road racing car. Finally, we have the Dodge Viper Anniversary Edition. A lot of people highly consider this in S1 and S2 class road racing, but starting off with S1, it gets destroyed by power builds on tracks full of straights. Okay, fair enough. And it isn't bad at the grip tracks, but the Ford GT is just better. Simple as that. Then in S2 class, wherever you go, you'll either be destroyed by the Brabham or by the Mosler. Choose your poison is essentially what it is, and it's the Viper that has no venom to poison. So the fact you see so many people use it online just shows how overrated it must be. And that's everything for this video. Let me know if you agree, and tell us what cars you think are overrated in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.